just plug my dinner. I think we can walk outside. Maybe we should just do this. We put ourselves in a diving suit and... Sight is a bit, restrained. It's not 4. Just scribble it down that way. F1. Maybe it's just which template we should use. Just note everything down with our notebook, make a sketch. This is where we came from. I would love to see how we really look in this suit. Okay. Hopefully we didn't forget a thing. That's it. Here. 1. We had... D9. 4. 9. This is 5. And the other one, 1 is H3. This is 0. So, F1, 3, and C8. It's 8. Okay, this makes a combination of 0, 8, 3, 5. Okay. Wait, these are five. We only have four plates. Okay, last one we have to try out, I guess. So, 0, 8, 3, 5. Last one is 3. Good. Okay. Let's head back. Okay, this was the hardest puzzle so far. These teleportation rays are unnerving.
I wouldn't try jumping if I were you. He couldn't control everything after all. I remember when this bridge collapsed not long before you came. It's a relief to see how time and nature together could outplay even him. How an unforeseen accident can ruin a life's work. I can't deny that his failure brings me joy. Unfortunately, I still need you to stay on his path. I think I may be able to guide you through. But first, I need to show you something.
Okay.
Now, follow me. You will not fall. Don't look down.
But I want to.
Just follow me.
I can't. May I?
Trust me.
Okay.
No need to hurry.
I don't hurry.
You must trust me.
I do. Maybe we could fall if I look down, but I don't want to try it.
This path leads to our sanctuary. He removed the crystals to darken these tunnels. Let's have some light. I suppose he wanted to hide this place from you. It's not far from here.
My own torch, thank you. Oh, it's some sort of mill, huh?
I brought him here once, too. Surprisingly, it is one of the only places he didn't ruin since then. But I doubt he kept it intact simply out of respect.
Okay.
This is the place we once called the Great Hall of the Amajat, the Shrine of the Seekers. You must look around and bind some blue crystal powder to cast into the fire.
This looks so cool. Come on. The key.
Have you found any blue crystal powder yet?
No, darling, no. But I will make some. Okay, let's head back to the mill.
We need blue crystal powder.
Yeah, I know. Well, okay. Some blue crystals. Ah. Comes.
Good. Now use the crane up there to throw the powder into the fire.
Okay. I like her voice. It's soothing. Again.
Use the crane.
Yeah, I do.
It is time I told you the story of my people. It is time you learned the truth about this world. The Dulmar was a great, noble, and prosperous civilization. They were people of peace, a thriving society of wisdom and art. Then, everything changed. At the dawn of the Third Age, we were attacked by the Shadows. Over the years, our colonies have fallen one by one. The Shadows have slaughtered our settlers without mercy. They filled our hearts with terrible fear. In the great halls of Unnatko, the capital city of our world, the Circle of Elders have chosen three of our best people. Roran, the most skilled warrior. Teodor, the brightest of all scholars. And a devoted shaman, me. We were called the Amajat, the Seekers. Our goal was to find a legendary place of great power, Quernalok. We embarked on a journey to face the unknown and to find what was hidden. This quest has forged a strong friendship between the three of us. Over the years, we visited countless worlds. We became exhausted and shattered under the weight of the responsibility. We learned that the Shadows had reached the outer walls of Unnatko. We almost lost faith, but we couldn't stop. As we kept searching, we found a world that astonished all of us. This very world. Here, we found what we needed the most. Time. Time to find a way. A way to save our people. Our worries trapped us here, knowing that our home is only safe if we stay on this island. The search was over. We knew that finding this island in our time of need was not an accident. It gave us hope, and we started to believe that this world was Quernalok. Over centuries, we perfected our expertise. We, the Amajat, have become idols of strength, intellect, and discipline. But it was not enough. The infinite time we have been given made us obsessed with the overcoming urge to save our people. As we kept training and learning, pursuing power slowly became our only passion. We had risen above the boundaries of the body and mind. Eventually, we almost forgot the very principle of our mission. And then, I had a vision of our people. I saw their suffering. At that moment, I understand we had become the very power we were sent to search for. It was time for us to head home. I knew we were prepared. We were ready to face them. But the shadows were no longer my worst fear. I was afraid of what we had become. I was afraid of facing reality. We appeared at the edge of doom. Most of our great city was burning in flames. Unatko, our home, was about to fall. And then, we vanquished our enemies. There was no fight. They couldn't fight back. We cleansed our city of the shadows. A war that had lasted years ended in seconds. We were the saviors. We were celebrated like gods. And that's exactly how we felt. But we knew that the people we saved were not really our people anymore. We no longer belonged here. We felt we were more. After witnessing our power, people lost their faith in the Council. We, the Amajat, have taken their place. But having fulfilled our destiny, the strong bond between the three of us started to fade. A new era has begun. The era of division and conflict. As our disagreements became stronger, we turned against each other. This caused the people to take sides. A war has erupted from within. A war we were too proud to stop. Chaos rumbled across the streets of Unatko. We watched our once thriving society fall apart. Our home was destroyed. All because of us. Because of what we have become. I couldn't live with myself. I couldn't bear the great emptiness I felt anymore. I left what remained of my world for one final journey. Following the path we once walked upon, I found Quel'Nalok once again. But I did not come back for its power. I came back to face the curse that made me forget who I was. I spent centuries meditating on my past mistakes, trying to find a way to make up for what I'd done. By accepting the loss of all attachments that kept me in the physical world, I managed to ascend to a new form of existence. In this way, I will never lose myself again, and I can guard this place for eternity.
Sad.
He didn't want you to know about our heritage. He didn't want you to see how the power of the island can ruin an entire civilization. He too wants to ignore it. But you must know the truth. He cannot accept the destructive power of this knowledge that he worships above all else. No civilization could contain this kind of power. Especially not a single person. It is time for you to return to his path. I will meet you back at the entrance.